I'm sorry to interrupt you, but does she get any response from the White House? I mean,
that's just what I just asked her. I just asked her the same question.
Because 32 years, if somebody is, I mean, doing this, and there are a lot of activists about it.
That's exactly what I just asked.
Particular issue.
Yeah.
What is her biggest concern?
What are your biggest concerns?
My concern?
Yeah.
Peace and stability in the world. Peace and stability to
peace
protect the planet from
honor
being destroyed.
No, but what specifically you need?
That is the main thing.
What
because
specifically
if they
need
get
she needs? What specifically do you need?
Peace and justice.
No, but this kind
peace
of
and justice.
General world.
Peace and justice, mister.
But you want peace and justice in the world, which is what a lot of us are fighting for. But you personally, as an individual, what do you need? I believe he's saying, what can people do to help you?
Peace and justice.
Occupy.
Peace and justice. By people getting involved. Mobilize everybody to do a mobilization for survival. People must think that we're going to destroy the planet. People going and supporting to go to satellites in the space. No, no one is going to live there. This is our land. This is the land for everybody in the world, and we have to protect it from these evil doers that are making wars, invasions, and unthinking and destruction. We got enough with the natural disasters. Would we need any more invasions and destruction of humanity and the environment?
What were you doing before you this idea came to your mind?
Pardon?
What were you doing?
This is my website right here in the bottom. Okay, that's my website, that's my name, that's my picture. On my website, you got professional videos for Michael Moore, Fahrenheit, even in German and many other. You got it all in there. Okay. Thank you. So this is what we need now, mobilize people. The people take over and demand it from the peacefully. Follow Gandhi legacy. Always peace. No violence because they are violent.
What is your message but to
follow Gandhi
what
legacy.
Is your message to White House?
They know. This is it. Peace stop the proliferation. But they don't listen to that. No, even Obama who campaigned change. Took office, didn't change anything. On the contrary. More weapons to Afghanistan, bombing Pakistan and Gaddafi in Libya for oil, he was doing like he was did in Iraq. So they are all the same. So it's the people. I repeat it again, you got to follow Gandhi. Sacrifice in demanding the government to stop it. Especially now that you got nuclear weapons too. That's very dangerous for an entire planet. Take these people to mobilize like these people doing now. These people start to mobilize. It does great. It's very good. It's all over now.
No, that is true. Usually people like you and me, we don't like war, right?
No, but you don't have a second. You people walk around like a robot. You're carrying cameras, taking pictures, moving around, but don't thinking. You have no brains. Robots don't have brains. And that's what your people do. Everybody who comes here is a robot. Because if people will think and people will have more concern, things will not happen. But people don't care. That's what I call them robots.
How do you support yourself?
Well, surviving.
How?
Survival. Surviving.
It's hard. I see, I mean...
Tell me about it. Tell me about it. Only God knows that. That's unbelievable. But
actually,
you
we
have
got
to keep it on.
I mean, now it came to our surprise. Last time when we came, before 5 years, I think in 2006, we saw you. But this time when we saw you, I mean, we got really surprised. I mean, and when we heard that you are here since 32 years.
Since 81. Yes, but it's still going on. Because it's the people, I can repeat it again.
What would satisfy you so you would not sit here? What would satisfy you?
Well, that's what these people doing. Occupy and overthrow these people out and make the world stability, for no more invasions, and wars, no more weapons. to keep the planet in one piece, not in pieces.
I think but her overall concern is peace and justice.
Yeah, but
yeah, it's not just for her or any selfish needs. Is she's basically saying the world needs peace and justice.
Yes, but that's what and everything. I mean, what she's doing. Why? I mean, one person, even president, cannot do it by himself, right?
That's absolutely
it's
true.
It's like the whole world need to be on this issue, and that's a kind of like huge issue. So,
and that's basically, I think, you know, not to put her words in her mouth, but what I'm getting from her is what she's saying is that the whole world needs to make a change. It's too much fussing and fighting, it's too much wars. She spoke of nuclear weapons and basically the destruction of the world. It's killing people, and people are getting so carried away and caught up with their own life. It's such selfishness, you know? That's what it's all about. I know with your culture, I'm assuming you're from India?
Or? Yes, India.
Yeah, and I'm pretty familiar with your culture and your background. I mean, you lift each other up. You come together as one.
Yeah.
Now, if the whole world would care and come together as one, I mean, the world would be a better place.
That's a wonderful idea, right? Mm-hmm. But it's an idea. I mean,
yeah.
It's not an idea.
Yeah.
It's a reality. Mm-hmm. It's a reality that we have the weapons, that we have the natural disasters. And if we people not wake up now, it's not going to be well for nobody. And that's the concern.
No,
everybody has the right to live
really
and life. Everyone has the right to live.
Yeah.
And people don't think about it, the others. People think only for themselves, everything for me. People have three, four houses, other people cannot have one room, and they don't care, because it's the greed for money and control. And that's why we have to mobilize people to think, not to be robots again, to think and think that we're going to destroy this planet, that the leaders, is not one leader and the world is good now. Everyone is corrupted, even money, it's all about money, and it's sick. And so
no,
much
my
people
dear,
suffering.
We
so
got
many people suffering for nothing.
That's true.
But this needs to be replicated in front of every president of every country of the world.
It definitely needs to be replicated in front of every president of every country in the world. Only one president cannot change it. How many countries in the world are there who will allow this kind of, even this kind of peaceful demonstration in front of their highest office or officer?
Yeah. Is this your daughter here?
Huh? Yes.
Your what do you think of this situation?
She probably doesn't.
What about this one?
She's more concerned about the cold right now.
And she survived it for 32 years.
We do agree what you are saying and everything.
Well, we just have to
and I think
if
majority...
Think we're going to.
No, everybody.
I talked to people here from all over the world, different levels of society,
mm-hmm.
and I keep on telling them the same thing. Each one in each country has to demand their government to stop us and think about the situation in the world, because that is the world is for everybody.
It's coming.
And concerned.
It's coming.
And that requires a lot of courage.
It has to be.
And this is the ground zero for courage.
But if all these occupied movements around the world, people listening.
Yeah, people.